Hello there, sixth graders. This is Miss Williams. I'm a sixth grade teacher at Penn Lincoln Elementary. Today we're going to talk about some figurative language. We're going to focus on two components of figurative language. So first of all, let's review what figurative language is. So figurative language is the use of words that go beyond their ordinary meanings. It requires you to use your imagination to figure out the author's meaning. Here's an example. The water's reflection was like the sun on glass. That's an example of a simile. So authors use figurative language to kind of make you imagine something more vivid in your mind, and it spices up your reading as well. So we're going to talk about hyperboles today. So a hyperbole is a figurative language where exaggeration is used for an emphasis. The example here is our teacher is so old, she probably taught cavemen how to make a wheel. Okay, so that's an obvious exaggeration. Obviously, your teacher is not that old, but it's trying to prove a point. Let's talk about hyperboles in music. So the first song I'm gonna play for you is Bruno Mars. It's called Grenade. Listen to the lyrics, and then we'll talk about if there's a hyperbole there or not. All right, so he says in that video, I'd catch a grenade for you, I'd jump in front of a train for you. That's an obvious exaggeration. He wouldn't literally do those things. But what do you think he's trying to say by saying those things to somebody? If he's willing to, jump in front of a train for them, he's trying to show them like, I love you so much, I would do anything for you. So that's kind of how we would interpret those lyrics. The next one is by One Direction. It is called Stole My Heart. So I'm gonna play you a little piece of that too. So they say there, you stole my heart. Also an exaggeration. You can't literally steal somebody's heart, but they're trying to prove a point that they love this person. So that's how we would interpret that. The next slide I'm going to show you, these are just some other examples of common hyperboles. I'll give you a second to look those through and then we'll talk about what they mean. So the first one, these new shoes are killing my feet. Not literally killing your feet, but that would mean that, these new shoes might be a little tight. I'm not used to wearing them, so they're hurting somebody's feet. The purple one, I was dying of shame when I fell in the puddle. You can't really die of shame, but I know we've all been there when we do something really embarrassing and you feel like you could just die, because you're so embarrassed. The next one, a lot of you are probably hearing this at home. It says, mom has told you a million times to clean your room. She literally tell you a million times? Probably not. But that's just trying to say like, hey, your mom has told you multiple times to go clean your room. And the last one, I use hyperboles like this all the time. I'll drive over to your house in 2 seconds. Will it really take 2 seconds? Of course not, but it's just an exaggeration. So those are some examples of other hyperboles. Next, we're going to talk about an onomatopoeia. That's a tricky word to say, but it is a word or words that imitate a sound. So the example here with the dog at the computer says the click, click, click of the computer keys gave Mrs. Jones a headache. So those words, click, 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 those are examples of an onomatopoeia. Authors use this a lot in their writing. To show, so that you can kind of almost like hear that sound in your head as you're reading. Some examples of onomatopoeias in music. The first one is Katy Perry, Firework. Go, her phrase there, where she says, make them go, oh, oh, oh. That's an example of an onomatopoeia. Another one, you might not be familiar with this, is the Black Eyed Peas. Their song is called Boom Boom Pow. And obviously the boom boom pow is already the example of a hyperbole, and it's in the title.
Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip, 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 dip. Boom, boom, boom. Gotta get dip. Boom, boom, boom. Gotta get dip. Boom, boom, boom. Gotta get dip. Boom, boom, boom.
So them saying boom, 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 you can kind of almost picture or hear, you know, like the booming, it's almost like the bass of someone's speaker. So here's some other examples. You probably see a lot of these in dialogue when you're reading. The first one's ah. So if, you know, the author's trying to show you that the character's scared or frightened, they might use that onomatopoeia. The word buzz, maybe, you know, an author, or sorry, a character's outside and there's, you know, a pesty bee that's flying around. The author might put that in their writing saying, you know, the buzzing of the bee. The next one's slam. So, you know, we've all heard the slamming of a door or something slamming. So an author might use that. And again, when you're reading, you might almost like picture that sound. And then we have a sigh, you know, like when you're done with all of your work for this week, you might sigh with relief. The next one's munch, if you're sitting on your couch right now, munching on some potato chips. And the last one's sizzle. A lot of times authors would use this, you know, maybe they're talking about the sizzling of the bacon that they're making for breakfast. So why we're talking about these is because it's important that you recognize them in your reading, and that you can kind of interpret what the author is trying to get across to you, without just coming right out and saying it. And also, you should be encouraged to use some of these in your writing too, just to make your writing more creative. All right, let's practice now. So what is this an example of? Bang, clang, and hiss are examples of what type of figurative language? If you said onomatopoeia, you are correct. Those are sound words. Bang, clang, and the hissing of the snake are all sound words. How about this one? Jimmy is so skinny, a skeleton looks fatter than he does. Okay, yes, that's an obvious exaggeration. That is a hyperbole. What the author's trying to say there is that Jimmy is just really skinny. You know, would a skeleton actually be fatter than him? Of course not. But it just kind of spices up the writing and makes it more creative. So whenever you're working on your hyperboles and onomatopoeias, don't get them confused. Try to use them in your writing and look for them in your reading. Make sure you're reading every day too. I hope everyone's safe and well, and I'll hopefully get to see some of you soon.